This is the all new Mahindra XUV500. Now in the traditional garage review style, I'll first show you around the car, showing you its new styling and the facelifted model of the new XUV500. Then I'm going to be talking about the features of this car, and then we'll be talking about the pricing and the practicality of this car, which is one of the most important things while buying a car. So please stick around for that. And for more other car reviews like this, consider subscribing to the channel. Now before starting, I would first like to give you an overview of this car. This car was first launched in the year 2011, and since then this car has just shot up in the Indian market. Given the good looks of this car that this car has always had, they have been continued to the new model as well. And along with that, according to many people, this car has one of the best driving dynamics of any Mahindra car as of now. And so that is what the XUV500 has always been about: the good looks and the driving dynamics. Now starting with the styling in this car, I'm in the front of the car, and one of the most evident changes from the previous model to the new XUV500 is the grille. You have a beautiful piano finish grille over here with chrome slats all over the grille, which gives this car a very stunning front end, and I really like this new grille design, which is really nice. Other than that, when we move to the headlight array in this car, we can see that we have projector headlamps for the low beams, and the high beams are normal halogen bulbs, which is the industry standard at this price point, and I think that's all right. We also get DRLs in this car, which have a very stunning design. The DRLs have also been updated from the previous model. In the previous model, you had that S kind of design on the DRLs, but now you get this straight line, which looks nice, and we also get halogen fog lamps in this car. Now moving to the side of this car, first we'll start with the alloy wheels in this car. Now this is not the top model, this is the W9 automatic version, whereas you can get a W11O automatic version, that is the top model for this car. And in the W9 version, you can see that you get alloy wheels, which is nice to see, as this is not even the top model and they're still giving you alloy wheels, so that's nice. And the one feature that the W11 gets over the W9 is that you get diamond cut alloy wheels in that car, but this car is still giving you alloy wheels, so that's nice. If you get a lower variant than that, you'll get normal steel wheels in that, so that's one thing you need to keep in mind. Other than that, we have 18 inch alloy wheels in this car, which is the perfect size for this kind of SUV, and I quite like that. Moving to the ORVMs in this car, they are electronically controlled and foldable ORVMs, and we get the integrated indicator lights, which is nice to see. Now the rear of the car is the main place where you actually see the difference from the previous version to the new ones. Instead of giving those tail lights which were always on the body of this car, now the tail lights have been divided into two parts. Half of them is on the tailgates, which get divided when you open the tailgate of this car, and half of them stay on the body of the car. And talking about the actual styling of the rear, it's quite controversial. Personally, I like it, but it comes down to personal preference. There are some people who like the styling of the previous version, but according to me, it looks really nice and goes with the look of the car. Other than that, we also get fog lamps for the rear of the car over here and on the other side. And one thing to notice is that this car has a lot of reflectors. Two are given on the bumper over here, rest one reflector, two reflector, three reflector, four reflectors on just one side on the top of the car, and so there are four on the other side as well. I guess the theory behind this is that this is a quite tall car, it's an SUV, so the people in the back should know that a big car is going in front of them in case the tail lights are not working, so the so that is the reason why they have given you so many reflectors, and I think that's a nice idea. Now coming inside the car, I would also like to talk about the styling within this car. There is a lot of plastic used inside the interior of this car, but there it is very high quality plastic, and the texture is they've given a very good wood texture on the plastic, which looks really nice, and the tan interior that this car has goes really well with the black interior of this car, along with the center console of this car, which has a piano black finish, which has very high quality. And every single button in this interior has a very satisfying click to it, which feels very nice to the touch. Now, as we're talking about the features of the new Mahindra XUV500, I would first like to start with the exterior of this car and with the tires once again. And the feature over here is that all four tires in this car have disc brakes, and I think that this is a very good feature, and I think it is needed in an SUV of this kind. Now, coming back to the ORVMs in this car, as I've already told you in the styling part of the video, that these are electronically foldable and electronically controlled ORVMs. But there is one more feature for the W11 optional package, that is that you also get a projection of the car you are driving. That is, when you unlock the car, the mirrors fold out and they give you a projection of the XUV500 badging down on the ground over here. I will show you a picture on your screens right now. This car doesn't have that feature, but the W11 optional packs does have that. But once you get inside the car, you're welcomed with a side plate in this car, which is chrome treated, as you can see. But this is the W9 model, that is why you get a chrome plate for the side plate in this car. If you buy the W11 optional package, you do get a lighted side plate in this car over here, which also says XUV500 in a very big script, which looks really nice within the interior of this car, and especially at night when you're driving with the interior lighting on inside the car. Yes, this car has interior lighting, I will get back to that later. The interior lighting in this car, along with the XUV500 badging, which is also lighted, goes down below, which looks really nice at night time. Now, moving inside the car, I would first like to start with the steering wheel in this car. It's a beautiful leather wrapped steering wheel with four spokes, and it is quite a steering wheel which has a very nice feel to it when you touch it all around. So that's really nice. And we get a multifunction steering wheel as well, where we have the infotainment display functions over here, volume control, mute button, and the media source, etc. And then you have the call buttons over here for cutting a call and picking up a call. And then we have the cruise control buttons over here. And one very special feature in this car is that you also get voice command. Now, the voice command in this car is something really different, as you can tell the voice command to actually turn up the AC or turn to a different channel on the infotainment display. So these are some really nice features in this car. Along with that, you also get automatic rain sensing wipers. This is a button over here for turning that on. And you also get automatic headlamps in this car, and that is the switch over here. Now, next we come to the gearbox in this car. It's a normal PR&DM gearbox that we have in any other car. But the interesting thing that you will notice over here is that when you put the car into the manual mode, there is no space for the gear level to move for upshifting or downshifting the car on its own, and this car does not have paddle shifters as well. So you might be wondering, how do you actually drive the car in manual mode? Well, the gear lever over here has this toggle switch over here, which has the manual settings on the toggle itself, which is really weird when you drive the car. For example, if you want to upshift, you have to push this lever forward, and similarly for a downshift, you have to push this lever back. So this is really weird placement, and I have not seen this in any other car. Now, moving to the center console area in this car, we have a center armrest which is also adjustable, so that's nice to see. And then we have a very special feature within this center console area. If you see down below, there is a toggle over there which is for the cooled center console area over here. How many cars have you seen that have a cooled center console storage area? I mean, this is the first car that I have seen in this price point, and I think that this is a really nice feature, and more cars should come up with this kind of feature. Mahindra infotainment displays have, according to me, been one of the best in the business. They offer so many features. I'll tell you the features of this infotainment display in just a moment. But first, listen to the welcome track that this infotainment display plays when you come and turn on your car.
Now, after the welcome screen, you're greeted with this screen. And first of all, about the infotainment screen, I would like to tell you guys that it's a very high quality infotainment screen, which is very responsive to the touch and has a lot of features. First, I would like to start with the car info tab over here, where you get a bunch of different options like fuel info, tyretronics, reverse camera, alerts info, service info, and e-manual. Now, if you've seen my Mahindra Scorpio review, I will link that in the description down below. You would know what Tyretronics is, but there is a difference between the Mahindra Scorpio and the Mahindra XUV500. Like, if you remember, in the Mahindra Scorpio, the Tyretronics showed you the exact temperature and pressure of each and every tire in the car, including the spare tire in the car. And the Mahindra XUV500 does have that Tyretronics, but it's a little different. As you can see, it's showing me okay, and okay for the spare tire as well. It is not showing me the exact temperature and the pressure that each of my tire is at. So I guess if one of the tire has low pressure, it would tell me that this tire has low pressure and it is exactly at that temperature and pressure. But right now it isn't showing me any kind of information like that. So I guess the Mahindra Scorpio infotainment screen is much better in that point of view. But there is one advantage to the screen in the Mahindra XUV, that is the graphics in this car are really nice. I mean, it is much better quality. And if you've seen, when I started this screen, there were a lot of different animations as well. For example, when I click fuel info, a car comes, and not just any car, the Mahindra XUV500 appears on the screen driving out of nowhere and saying that the distance to empty for this car is that much. Right now the car is turned off, so I can't show you that. Anyways, also for the Tyretronics, a Mahindra XUV comes and parks into a position over here where it tells me the position of each and every tire and what its condition is. So that is really nice. Now moving on to the alerts tab in this car, where we have different type of alerts in this car. Now I have shown you this tab in the Mahindra Scorpio review as well, and I have told you the advantages of this tab in that review, so I won't be repeating that. Anyways, I have linked that in the description below, so if you want to go check that out, you can. And so this alerts tab is one of my favorite in any infotainment display. And by far my favorite feature in any Mahindra infotainment display is the e-manual. And what that does is that it gives you a bunch of different options, and it contains each and every feature of the car, and it gives a video explanation of every feature that the car has. I'll give you a little example. I'll open infotainment over here and I'll go for driver information system. When I press that, it will give me a video explanation of each and every feature of this infotainment display. As you can see, I'll turn up the volume info right now.
Or selection of car info on the home screen will display the vehicle information section. This section contains fuel info.
And so you see that this is one of the most elaborate infotainment displays I have ever seen in any system, and I truly love this feature. This car also has ambient lighting inside it, but it's only of one color. But anyways, you're getting that feature, so you can't really complain. And that button is over here. When you press it, you can see that the driver's footwell and the passenger footwell just lit up in the blue color. And same story is above the sunglasses holder in this car. You get a blue lighting strip over here, and in the door panels as well. Every place that you can imagine where ambient lighting could be, this car has given it, and it truly looks amazing. And I can just imagine sitting in this car at night time with all this ambient lighting around me. Now last but not the least, this car also has a sunroof in this car. It's an electronic panoramic sunroof, which is controlled by the two buttons given on the roof of this car. They're one touch control buttons, and you just need to press them once to open the sunroof in this car. And similarly, the sunroof can also be closed by a one touch button. And
now this car has a third row seating area as well, and I will now show you how to get inside the third row seats. There is a lever behind both the seats in the back area over here. So I pull this lever and I pull this seat area down, and you may be wondering that if these seats go forward at all. No, they don't. So this is all you get to go inside.
It is during the shooting of the video that I realized that the seats can also go all the way up.
Now once you get into the third row seats, you can see that the third row seats are quite compact and you don't get much of leg room over here, but the headroom is quite substantial. The features I would like to talk about in third row seating is that you do get AC vents for the third row passengers as well, but the great part is that you can also control the speed individually for the third row passenger seats. This feature is not even available for the second row passenger seats, and so they thought of giving it for the third row seats, which I think is quite amazing, and I do like this feature.
SUV 500 starts at 12.37 lakhs and goes up to 19.80 lakhs, that is the showroom prices, and the mileage claimed by the company is 15.1 kmpl. There are total 13 variants of this car, which you can see on your screens right now, and the maintenance cost is almost about 7038 rupees per year.
Now moving with the practicality in this car, I would first like to start with the storage coverage that the Mahindra XUV has all around its cabin. First, we start with the passenger side in the front seats, where we have two kind of glove storages. First is on the top, where we have a decent amount of storage space over here. As you can see, it's quite deep and is quite tall as well, so you can get a decent amount of stuff stored in there. Next, we have the actual glove compartment, which has been divided into two parts with this tray over here, which can also be removed, so you have a larger space to keep your stuff. Other than that, we also have a storage space over here, which is divided from the rest of the part to keep your stuff organized. And talking about organization, you also have a card holder over here for keeping your visiting cards, etc. I've already talked about the center console storage in this car, where you have a decent size storage over here, which is very deep and quite large, which is also cooled, which is a nice feature. Other than that, one thing I didn't tell you is that this is also divided into two parts. I showed you the previous storage right now, but now I will show you the other storage in this car, where you this is the storage I was already talking about. Now this is the second storage, where you have a coin divider over here to keep your coins organized. Other than that, you also have a felt covered center console area over here, which is also quite decent in size for keeping other small stuff. There is another storage space in this car on the dashboard of the car, which is also closable, and the cover of that storage space opens ever so slightly. When it's opened, you can see it's quite deep and has a plastic film over here, which can be removed to keep any dust outside. So that's nice, and it's quite deep. You can get a lot of stuff stored inside this. Now last but not the least, moving to the roof in this car, you also have a sunglasses holder over here, where you can keep your sunglasses. Now moving to the trunk in this car, I would first like to talk about opening the trunk. There are two ways to open this trunk, and first is on the key fob, and second is in the request sensor given under the trunk over here. Once you open the trunk, you can actually notice that when the third row seats are in position, that is when they are up, the trunk space in this car is minimum. Like, there is only 93 liters of trunk space when the third row is up. But the trunk space in this car can also be increased by putting down the trunk, the third row seats in this car, which is fairly easy. Once you put down the third row seats, the bed becomes relatively flat, not completely flat, but it's okay. And when the third row seats are down, you can see that you have quite enough space to put any kind of luggage. Even with when you are with a big family and you want to go for a long road trip, you won't have any kind of problem regarding luggage in this car. Now moving to the rear seats in this car, given the size of the car, the seat storage for the rear passengers is quite conservative. You get these seat nets over here for the passenger and the driver side over there. And other than that, you also have some storage in the door pockets with a 1 liter bottle holder over here. Other than that, there is only just two cup holders for the rear passenger seat, that is also in the rear armrest of this car. Other than that, in the rear seats, you don't have any kind of storage for the rear seat passengers. Now in the third row seats of the Mahindra XUV 500, I guess this is the place where you actually have a little bit more storage than the second row seats. You get these nets on both sides of the third row seats, and you get two cup holders as well on both sides. Other than that, you also have these small little seat storages on
either side of the third row seats, which I guess are really nice, and they're also covered, so that's an added benefit.
And so next we talk about the seat comfort of the XUV 500. I'm sitting in the passenger side seat right now, and I can obviously move the seat back and forth as in every other car. And there is an additional benefit on the driver's side seat of the height adjustability, and it's all manual. But if you buy the W11 optional package, you do get the driver's side seat all fully automatic. That is moving the seat back and forth and the backrest back and forth along with the height adjustability. All of that is motorized in the W11 package. But this is the W9 model, so you don't get that feature in this car. But it is one thing worth noting. Other than that, when we talk about the actual comfort in these seats are very comfortable, and the seat material is very soft, due to which you actually just get snuggled into your place, and you get very supportive seats as well, which is really nice for any kind of long road trip. Now, talking about the seat comfort in this rear seats, I have the front seat in the position where I would sit, and I'm quite tall. I'm 6 feet tall, and as you can see, I still have about 10 inches of legroom available to me. Can you literally believe that this is the place where you want to sit when you are sitting in this car? This is like one of the biggest legrooms I have seen in any car. And talking about the headroom, that is quite low, and I'm actually being quite sarcastic when I'm saying low. I have about 5 inches of headroom, but I was saying it in comparison to the legroom I have available to me. So anyways, the seat material is same as the front seat, so you do have this, that same material, that softness when you're sitting in these seats, and they are quite comfortable, and hence when you're going on a long road trip in this car, you won't have any kind of problem in the rear seats of this car. And so that was my review on the all new Mahindra XUV 500. According to me, this is a very nice car with lots of features and one of the most practical SUVs I've seen. And special thanks to Mahindra Industrial Area Panchkula for giving me their car for a review. The people over here are great. They'll be happy to help you if you want to know any more other information on the new Mahindra XUV 500 or any other Mahindra car. Then you can look in the description down below. I've given every single detail you might require. Thank you.